begin this sacred liturgy with our blessing of the fire. Go ahead at this time and get your candles, please. And if they're not already lit, we'll light them. Sisters and brothers, on this most holy morning, when Jesus passed from death to life, the Church invites us all to enter into the Paschal Mystery. While we cannot be physically together this morning, we know that when we gather in any way to pray in His name, Christ is present among us. Our Easter candles are a symbol of Christ's presence. As the flame consumes the wax, it gives of itself in the form of light and warmth. We are called to embody the Christ light by giving of ourself in love and service to others. In communion of heart and spirit with the whole Church, let us celebrate the light of Christ, the living light in our midst. Together we'll pray this prayer. God of all creation, who through your Son bestowed us with the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor. We ask this through Jesus, the light of the world. At this time, trace a cross on your candle, and we pray, Christ yesterday and today, in the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to Him in all the ages. To Him be glory and power through every age and forever. By His glorious and holy wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and protect us. Amen. May the light of Christ who rises in glory dispel all darkness. Please lift your candles. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God. In your love, Holy One, we open our hearts to personal growth and unity. May we truly be agents of light
and love in our world. Give thanks for being called into a relationship with you that is holy. Fill our hearts and souls with the wisdom and grace to know what truth is.
Loving God, Jesus revealed that nothing can separate us from your infinite love.
Help us to grow in your love to renew each other, ourselves, and all creation. We ask this in God's holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Spirit of God, grant us the power to be gentle, the strength to be forgiving, the patience to be understanding, and the courage to accept the consequences of holding on to what is right.
Come, Spirit of God, help us to put our trust in the power of good to overcome evil,
the power of love to overcome hatred, and the power of light to illuminate the darkness.
Come, Spirit of God, help us to put our trust in the power of good to overcome evil, the power of love to overcome hatred, and the power of light to illuminate the darkness. Come, Spirit of God.
Come, Spirit of God, enlighten us with the vision to see and the faith to believe in a world free from violence, a new world where fear will no longer lead us to allow injustices, nor selfishness cause us to bring suffering to others.
Come, Spirit of God.
And come, Spirit of wisdom and love, source of all that is good, teach us your truth and guide our actions in your way of peace.
Amen.
You fertilize us in your wisdom. Moses to the Israelites, sang this song to Yahweh. To you, Yahweh, I sing. You have triumphed powerfully. Horse and chariot tear you have flung into the sea. Yahweh is our strength and our courage. You have become our deliverance. The word of God.
Thanks be to God. I love the opening line of this passage. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward." So often we expect God to do our work for us. We expect life to be easy as a reward for being faithful disciples. Holy Week reminds us that this world will always have its challenges. God is not going to swoop in and remove our obstacles. We will have to face them. We will have to cross the sea. But God also does not leave us alone in this effort. Discipleship comes with its privileges, but it also comes with its responsibilities. God tells Moses to command the Israelites to do their part, go forward. Once they begin to move forward, God provided them the help that they needed to succeed. We have become so familiar with the story of Moses leading the Israelites across the Red Sea, we sometimes forget that Moses did not act alone. He was part of a much larger community. There is a significant character in the story who often gets overlooked, the prophetess Miriam, Moses' sister. I have on the screen here a picture of Miriam that's hanging in our hallway in our house. It was painted by a Jewish friend of mine, Carolyn Frankel, and is part of her award-winning book, Be Like Rachel, which highlights the many women of the Hebrew Scriptures who are often forgotten when we share our biblical stories. Miriam played a key role in Moses' life as a baby. She watched over him as he floated down the Nile in exile. And when he was rescued by Pharaoh's daughter, Miriam interceded and arranged for their mother to care for him. At this point in the story, as Moses fulfills his divinely ordered role to save the people, Miriam too participates in this act. If we read a bit further into the chapter, we find a beautiful song, Miriam's song, celebrating the successful journey across the Red Sea. Miriam was the first woman in the scriptures to be named a prophetess, and she leads the women in song and prayer after the Israelites successfully cross the sea as she plays her tambourine.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. So Peter said to them, "I begin to see how true it is that God shows no partiality, rather that any person any nationality fears God and does what is right is acceptable to God. You yourselves know what took place throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee with the baptism John proclaimed. You know how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, and how
disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and he believed. They still did not understand from the scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. They saw. Before this reading, we see Jesus' disciples in the laws of Roman burial. The faithful took down the body of Jesus, and Joseph of Arimathea not only gave Jesus the tomb, he provided the prescribed 100 pounds of embalming oils and spices needed before lying him to rest. However, the ministry of preparation of the body was solely done by women. They were called mitrophores, also known as mirth bearers or mistresses of the oils. They were skilled in helping people attain their highest good, particularly for approaching death or had died. Mary of Bethany, Martha, Mary of Magdala, and Mary the mother of Jesus were probably mitrophores, mistresses of the oil. This is probably the reason we hear their names throughout all four Gospels. Devoted to ministry, society, quote, allowed women to have, end of quotes. Each woman you were to faithfully attend to the people to whom they were called, from birth to death. Beyond the structural confines of societal and religious law, women like Mary and Beth were the first to, quote, see beyond those limitations, see with the heart, that same heart of Jesus whose love bent toward her breast, and ask his beloved disciples to love as I have loved. To see with the eyes of Jesus changed women who in turn changed societies. Women throughout history have moved in and out of the boundaries placed on them to do the centuries-old work of caring for the people, healing the sick, binding their wounds, speaking against institutional injustices, and calling others to discipleship. Yes, women were and are apostles and disciples of Christ. Women have seen Christ as bearers of good news. At certain times in history, men of the church have gotten a glimpse of that faithfulness and have been amazed. Yet the people of God have known this truth to proclaim anew.
Yes.
Oh, very good.
You're on the screen so we can see you.
Candle.
Yes.
And so the first part of this is that all of you who have the water, place your hands over the water. Who by your power accomplished wonderful things through your sacraments, and who in many ways have prepared the water to be the gateway of the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit, in the first moments of the world's creation, hovered over the waters, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, who caused the children of Abraham to pass through the Red Sea to be set free from slavery. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed by the Holy Spirit, the Son who hung on the cross and gave water and blood from his side, and who after resurrection commanded his disciples, go forth and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, on the face of your church, and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water, received by the Holy Spirit,
So I'm going to put the screen back up now, and in place of our profession of faith, we will do a renewal of our baptismal promises while you have your water still present. Please respond to the following questions with I do. Do you reject darkness as to live in the freedom of God's light? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of God?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the universal church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. It is the faith of the church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please respond to each petition. Risen Christ, our life and love, hear our prayer.
Risen Christ, our life and love, hear our prayer.
We are grateful for the wholesomeness of life and for the gift of good health. Aware of the unity of body and spirit, we affirm our constant need for their harmony if we are to enjoy true health. Grant us wholesomeness and holiness, especially as we struggle through this pandemic, we pray. Risen Christ, our life and love, hear our prayer.
We are grateful for the marvels of medicine, for doctors and nurses, for all those who possess a healing touch and practice the art play. Keep all who are on the front line safe and healthy, we pray.
Risen Christ, our life and love, hear our prayer. We are thankful for the way in which our own bodies work to constantly heal themselves, restoring us to the state of health. We acknowledge that when we have been healed of depression and gloom by laughter and affection, healed of inner injury by the medicine of forgiveness,
to this liturgy all of the intentions that we hold in our hearts. We pray. Risen Christ, our life and love, hear our prayer. Lifting our bread, we pray. Blessed are you, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Lifting the wine, we pray. Blessed are you, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Holy Mystery, we offer this prayer with humble spirit and contrite hearts. May we and our gifts be acceptable to you, and may they bring us health of mind, body, and spirit.
Peacemakers who transform our church and society.
you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our failings, but on the faith of your people, and grant us peace and unity in accord with your will. The peace of Christ be with you always. You are invited to share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. I will unmute everybody and share the screen so we can see each other.
Yes, for the breaking of the bread. Loving God, if you call us to live the gospel of peace and justice, be with you. Loving God, you call us to be your presence in the world. We will love tenderly. Loving God, you call us to seek truth to power. We will walk with integrity.
This is the bread of life and the cup of blessing. How blessed are we who are called to this table.
Jesus,
you affirm our worthiness and nourish by your word. We will help to heal the world. You are the body of Christ.
Amen.
Receive the cup of blessing. Let us pray. Loving God, you renew us with the spiritual nourishment in this bread and wine. Watch over and inspire us to be word and sacrament for others. Through our partaking in the sacred meal, transform us to become your body present in our world. We ask this in your holy name.
Amen.
Just a real quick announcement. Thank you to all who helped make our liturgy so beautiful, especially the second part of Lent and Holy Week and Easter. I know it was challenging the way we had to pull them all together, and I'm very much grateful for everybody's effort, and I think in spite of the challenges, we really did a great job, so thank you to all of you. We will not be gathering for Vespers tomorrow evening, Easter Monday. We'll take a little bit of a break. We will have a rosary at 3 o'clock on Wednesday, and then Sunday, of course, 11 a.m. liturgy next Sunday, and then the following Monday we'll be back on our 6 p.m. Vespers. If you're not yet signed up on our newsletter on our website, please do so. The benefit to that is we do send out a weekly newsletter, and in that weekly newsletter has all of our online liturgies, and the links for Zoom are included on them. That way you'll have all in one newsletter. You'll have all the links that you need for the week. You can always email me as well, but the newsletter is certainly a great way to keep track of that. Really, from the bottom of our hearts, because it is keeping us able to keep operating. Even though we're not open, we still have the same overhead costs and obviously increased technology costs now. So we certainly thank you for supporting in that way. And the flowers and palms and all of the beautiful beautiful vessels and gifts that we received to help make this season so beautiful, we very much appreciate it. So thank you. Hopefully this time next year we will be in person, and we'll be celebrating our Holy Week liturgies in this beautiful space together. So, any other announcements or anything anybody needs to share before we move into our closing?
Thank you, Shanon, for pulling all of it together and keeping us together at this time. We couldn't have done it without you.
Thank you.
Amen.
But honestly, I'm so grateful. You know, it was a little frustrating Friday, but in the wider scheme of things, I know we're at the mercy of the internet, and that's okay, because I think having this opportunity to be live together has made all the difference, at least for me. It's just not the same as having a pre-recorded video, so.
It was great. It changed the whole outlook at our house for having lost the Easter spirit, because we were still able to keep it.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you. Happy Easter.
Yeah, happy Easter to everybody. So I will, once we do the concluding song, if you need to go, you know, obviously you can sign out anytime, but if you'd like to hang on for a few minutes, I'll remove my screen share so everybody can see each other if you want to share any Easter blessings with each other. So, with that, we will pray together our final blessing. I am going to mute you just for 1 second for this in the song, only because of the reverberation, and then I'll unmute for us to visit at the end. So, Please extend your hands and pray with us. Loving God, in this moment, as we celebrate your glorious resurrection, you make us aware of our potential to create heaven here on earth. Send your Spirit, the living light, to illuminate our path through the holy season of Easter. Be with us as we find ways to creatively love within our homes, communities, places of work, and our world. Give us the courage to sow seeds of light and love wherever you call us to be. We ask this in your holy name, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Amen.